Today we discuss about hill stream adaptations. Generally, the life surviving in a particular areas like streams. So generally, some organisms lives in hot spots and hot springs. Okay. So generally, in hill streams, the more number of fishes are can survive in this peculiar environment. Generally, whenever the competition is very high on the water bodies. These organisms try to migrate to a special ecological niches and adapt their niches. Then only they can increase their population. So generally the adaptations are developed, then only they can increase the populations. So generally the organisms living in sluggish water, they are migrate to lower streams and again migrate to upper streams. Okay. So generally upper streams are nothing but hill streams. The hill streams are which is coming out of the mountains. Okay, so the especially migration for food, shelter and protection from predators, and one more thing, reproduction. So these are the main aims present in the migration. The migration for food, shelter and protection from predators and reproduction. Okay, some special adaptations are there or special modifications are there. So what is the modification? Modification is a special organ which is present in the organism whenever it is entering into a new environment. Generally the organisms whenever entering the new environment, the organisms can develop some adaptations. Like this is hill stations. So generally the fishes having special structures and suckers and flattened body and mouths and some fluffy bodies also present. Okay, so now first modification is shape. Generally the greatly flattened head and body, the greatly flattened head and body. So these organisms looks like leaves. For example, Balitora, Gleptosternum, Gleptothorax, pseudo echinus. Generally you know about echinus, which is present in the seawater. This echinus attaches to the shark fish for migration and collection of food. So here the pseudo echinus is there. Generally the dorsal surface mostly arched, the dorsal surface is mostly arched like, and the flattened is belly is flattened at the bottom. The flattened belly is there above dorsal surface is there. So leaf like body useful for living in the streams. Head is small and semicircular. Head is small and semicircular. So okay, this is about shape. Second one is size. Small in size, heavy, short and thicker body. Small in size, having short and thicker body. So hide under rock. So this is a special adaptation to hide under the rock. Okay, this is about size. And scales and bony armors. Generally the organisms having different type of scales generally. So the poorly developed, because the scales and armor, bony armor poorly developed, remain and furrows from protecting from predators. So generally poorly developed because remain in furrows, remains under in furrows and protecting from predators. Okay, so generally the ventral side scales are absent. Ventral side scales are absent, so there is no need of ventral scales. And mouth, so in this organism, crescent or semicircular mouth is present, and jaws are strong. Okay, so schizothorax, these characteristics present in schizothorax. Lips, generally the lips having suckers, especially the lips having sucker to attach to the plants and rocky rocks. Okay, used for scooping the muds and clinging on stones. Hamaloptera. This is about lips. And barbells, especially the specialized barbells are present in these organisms. So greatly reduced, being short and stumpy, so the examples for the Balitora and Gleptothorax and pseudo echinus. Okay, so next, ice, small in size, the push towards the upper surface of the head. Generally, this is the one of the adaptation to see the peripheral parts above the head. So then only the eyes push toward the upper surface of the head. Example, Baltora, Glyptothorax and Pseudoechnis Glyptospermum. Okay, these are the about eyes. Fins, the especially fins for locomotion. These fins for attachment to the substratum, attached to the rock. This about. We have the paired fins. Two types of fins are there, paired fins and muscular fins. The Astrolobes chitae sucker suctoral mouth. So the Astrolobes chitae having sucker fins and suctoral mouth. Okay, so muscular fins are present in Homoloptera. Muscular fins are present in Homoloptera. Pectoral and pelvic girdle. Generally, the well-developed girdles are present. Keel-like and ridges present ventral surface. So these are the keel-like. So especially for movement in the streams, and the ridges are present and ventral surface. Okay, these are present in ventral surface. And special organisms, breathing apparatus. Okay. Generally, especially air bladder is present. So air bladder is nothing but hydrostatic organ which is present in the fish. But here, the well-developed air bladder is present. So this is hydrostatic organ. Adhesive device. So avoid swept away. So this adhesive device useful for avoid swept away. So here, generally, the Asiatic Silurnis, especially these are the catfish, these are having adhesive disc and bare surface ridge in ventral side. So generally these are having ridges in ventral side. Okay, so these are the special types of adaptations. Next, streams. Generally the streams are freshwater farms which is present in the hill areas. So generally the streams are young streams, and streams are three types: young streams, major streams, old streams. Generally the young streams are near to the hill areas. So here the water current is very high. That is the reason why in this area the limited fauna and flora is present. In mature streams, especially these are nothing but flood plains. So these nearly in Himalayan region, Bangar, Terai, these mature streams are present. So these mature streams water current is very slow when we are comparing with the young streams. Okay, so here the different types of flora and fauna is inhabited. Why? Because the low water current. So this is the special adaptation. And old age streams, nothing but these are can make oxbow lakes. Here the some organisms can inhabit it. Number of flora and fauna is present. Okay, number of flora is and fauna is present. Different ecological niches are present, and here the organisms live on the air like insects and birds, and the organisms live in the water, fishes and some insects and vertebrates, invertebrates, and the organisms which lives in burrows of the sand or soil, lithosphere. Okay, so the three environment having flora and fauna. Okay, and one more thing here, the more amount of unicellular algae is present, so these can make the food chains, then only the carnivore organisms are developed. Carnivorous organisms are developed. So after old age streams, now these streams and ready to enter into the sea. Okay, so generally the streams can carry the silt. The streams can carry the silts. Generally in young streams, especially the waterfalls are formed. Where the young streams are present, there is a waterfalls. These waterfalls can create a beautiful area. So these waterfalls having ecological tourism spots, ecotourism spots. So these ecotourism spots having some, they can attract the international ecological friends and international tourists. Then only it can develop. And one more thing here, the way the mature fields are present here, the some flood plains are there. So some rivers like Mississippi, Missouri, they can change always its path. Then only some flood plains are formed. So So sometimes this is also lead to agriculture lossage of agriculture fields, and floods are takes place. So you know about Hoyangho, that is the river which is present in Bengal state. So it may also create this type of floods. Okay. So these are the different types of streams. Okay, streams. Generally, the organisms which lives in the streams having special characteristics. So first one is shape, greatly flattened and head and body, and size, scales and bony armors, and mouth, lips, and barbels, and eyes, and fins, and pectoral and pelvic girdles, and breathing apparatus. And here we have to discuss about one more thing here, the fish's migration. Generally, the oceanodromic migration and anadromic migration and catadromic migration. Generally, the anadromic migration, the migration from sea to freshwater. The migration takes place from sea to freshwater. Like anguilla, sea eel. Anguilla, it is a sea eel. So generally, the anguillas, mature anguillas, are lives in the sea. Whenever the reproductive time is there, generally these total male and female migrate to the freshwater streams, and sardinia fishes also this type of migration takes place. Okay, these anguillas reaches to their birthplace, the fishes where the birth, and there is the reproduction takes place, mating takes place, and the female lays the eggs and male lays the ova, sperm. So here the external fertilization takes place. So after completion of fertilization, the larvae are formed. These are called leptocephalous larvae. So these larvae can migrate into sea. They can migrate into sea. So these larvae nearly spend 2 to 3 years in the sea to collect the food. Then only some metamorphosis takes place. So from now the adults are produced. So this process takes place every year. So whenever this migration takes place, the more amount of abundant food sources available to the rest of all organisms, which is ready to feed on the organisms which is present in the water, like birds and insects and turtles, snakes and gangetic gharials, different types of predators are there at that particular region. Even though lions, tigers also can catch the fishes. Okay, so hyenas and whatever it may be, the cheetahs can collect the fishes. The cheetahs are also depending upon for fish for food only. So according to availability of food sources, the organisms are depend. So this is about especially migration. So now this is about fish migration. Here the oceanodromic migration is there, and potadromic migration is there, catadromic migration is there. So one more thing, catadromous migration. The migration takes place from freshwater to sea. So Ilisha, it is the one of the fish. So this fish migrate to sea for reproduction. So this is vice versa to anadromous migration. So whenever these fish entering into the seawater, generally the water salinity is very high, although it can tolerate the salinity problems. Here what mechanism takes place in the gills of the fishes, especially the high salts are present in the seawater. Now the more amount of salts entering into the body, the excess salts excrete by the chloride cells which is present in the gills. Okay, the by the losing of water from its body, so the more amount of water drinked by these fishes. Okay, so by that they can get more amount of chemically active water, the excess salts excreted by the gills, chloride cells, and kidneys. So this is one of the adaptation where the freshwater organisms entering into the sea. Now whenever the seawater organisms entering into the freshwater, here the more amount of water, free water molecules are available here. So then only more amount of water entering into the body. So the body fluids are diluted. for avoiding that, the organisms can collect the salts from fresh water, especially the gill cells having chloride cells. These chloride cells can absorb the salts and entering into the blood. So the excess water excreted by the kidneys. So these are the adaptations. These are the adaptations. How the organisms can survive. Okay. So these are the hill stream adaptations. Okay. Shall we stop here?